got the Tigers on the floor. The Tigers coming back in. By Mason Marquez have been the only two players who are still to score here in the fourth quarter. Good steal by Perry to John Williams. He comes back with a fast break.
It was a 4-1 situation at cross time to kind of dangerous because at the side of Perry Santalla, there was Vargas, there was Watson, and the quick hands of Watson. He paid 2 points.
Well, Perry has one weakness in this game. It's his ball handling skills. That's how he could not get the pass off for the easy two.
Line is down to 6-44. 9-9 for Gilbey Sonic, 92 for Peter Hausen. He's heading out of the house. Good cover, coming from the bow. Here's Watson, looking for room. And Mon has it. And Mon Fernandez quickly. It's Guerra. The pitch is only one left. Guerra.
Oh, good shot for Guerra. Maybe he tried to be a little too pretty that time. He should have just put his straw into Watson to try to at least get the foul instead. Oh, tough rebound by Reynosa.
It's a tough tackle. Time is down to 6:05. 5 teams out. Here's the Deer House. 4-4 against Gilbey. Watson on Mon Fernandez. It's a foul call against Steve. Blocking foul. That is going to be his fifth personal foul. It is under 6 minutes. We have timeout. Norma Black and I will be right back.
Let's talk with Norman Black on the personal foul situation.
Well, for the Gilbey team, Watson has 5, Dukas has 5, and Sedania has 4. There is players in foul trouble for Bierhausen, and Stella Rosa with 4, Sanchez with 5, and Gutierrez with 5.
A single roll, coming from a very strong move. Mon Fernandez cuts down the lead of Gilbey Sonic to 5. Here's the picture, he'll take it in. What a nice save, he's flashing through the air.
Yes, it would be nice if he could get this play on replay. As Sonny went to the hoop really strong this time, you see him coming down the middle of the lane, nobody stops him, and Fernandez is going to get the foul.
101 for Gilbey Sonic, looking for his 17th point. Here's Reynosa. Pull down his fifth rebound, 3-2. Time is 5:37. Mon Fernandez. Here's the 1-1 on Watson. One pump. Good hit. Now, the franchise goes to work. He's got a total of 31 points. Having 6 here in the fourth quarter.
Mon is trying to save the day for his team.
Gilbey goes up by 5. Time is 5:16. Here's Gary Vargas. He's strong. He's got the hand. He's strong. Shot. Looking downstairs. And they're not trying to check it. This is a shot to above balance. And Jaworski immediately lets go for Watson. Nobody there. 15.
Oh, loses the ball. It slips out of his hands that time, Pinoy. Fernandez comes back up. Terry Saldana steals the ball. Passes to Jaworski.
What a big save for Terry Saldana. Transition getting to be erratic. They've got to settle down. You heard it during the coaching huddle with Shereen Valenzuela. This is not a shooting match. You've got to be wise. You've got to think. And a reaching in foul call against Mon Fernandez on a bounce pass intended for Terry Saldana.
And that's going to be Mon's fourth foul. It's also going to be Bierhausen's 17th foul. So that means they're over the limit. We have a timeout, Pinoy. We'll be right back.
Has four, Pasco, Vargas, the West
see they have three apiece. Heather Lau has two. On the part of Phil Hausen, Juan Fernando Carlos, four personal fouls. Velosa will foul. They have three apiece. Esquerra has two and Gutierrez one. Here's the PJ looking for a cutter. 30 on the shot clock. He won, has it, and he has Esquerra putting it down. 60 to Mon.
And Gilbey's had to get back on defense, but here comes Pierre Hausen. Gutierrez goes up and he scores with a reverse layup.
That has to be a duel of a reverse. It is now a three-point game with 4 minutes and 4 seconds.
This is the way we expected it to be. It's a knockout game. We expect it to come right down to the wire.
It is a cardiac game. And here is Eddie Saldana looking for room. Difficult shot.
Shot by Terrence Adjani that time. He didn't even see the basket. He put it up there.
Heather Lau bumping on Mike Duhal, bringing them now to the 16th foul, and Heather Lau will be his first personal foul. But here comes Francis Alliance for Willie.
I guess when the going gets rough, the rough gets going.
And a warning has been called on the bench of Pierre Hausen. Alfonso was really pleased that there was no foul called on the shot of Gutierrez. Here is Mon. He will go for three.
And there was a foul call that time. Coach Carbonell is still saying that it should have been a flagrant foul because somebody was kicking their foot out. Mon has a chance to cut this game down to 2-4.
And the situation here is that Pasco getting a fourth personal foul also brought Gilbey Gintonic to the 17th foul.
Yes, now both teams are over the limit and Pasco has just gone out. Ed Duke has just checked in.
Now Duke is carrying five personal fouls and easy assigned to keep an eye on Juan Fernandez, and you don't mind your pushing on him. A 3-point play coming from Juan Fernandez. Cuts down the lead of Gilbey to two.
And all of a sudden the fans are booing Gilbey.
As always, you're leading and then there's a press on the team to try to catch up. They're going to go for the underdog. And we have illegal defense called against Juan Fernandez. It is a warning call against Pierre Hausen.
Well, Gutierrez is also going to have to make up his mind. He was in the middle that time. He didn't know whether to go double team or to go back to his man.
Time is down to 3 minutes and 20 seconds. Strong combination of the backcourt here for Gilbey Gintonic. The big jam passes the night. They go back a long way. Gary, he is very visible. Tight on him to go out to pass it. He will zigzag. He spots. Nice shot!
Clutch hit by our nice that time. Off the backboard.
And that's the reason why they call him Mr. Clutch. He only had a basket during the first half. Bumping another big eight in the second half.
Well, everything from now on will be clutch hit as we're now under 3 minutes.
Here is Mon, he zigzags, big shot, and there he finds a storm of the moment. He just pulled down his 11th rebound, 5 and 6, Gary Vargas, and then Gary Saldana. Here is Dorsey, you heard it during the last huddle. Sure shot, take your time. 9 on the shot clock, Francis finds the opening, he loses it downstairs, good ball, pass it out, and here he comes, he is in control, and there is a foul, maybe calling it Gary Vargas, who is pressing on the ball. We have a very rugged play here.
Yes, because Michael Cobb threw his elbow out that time, he could have also been called for a foul, but instead it's going to go against the Gilbey team, and Michael Cobb will be on the line for two. We have it on the replay here. Brought to you by San Miguel Beer. You can see the elbow hit Gary Vargas right in the face.
And Mike Vargas collected himself very quickly. Went over to Gary Vargas, told him about that friend. There are buddies, and we have Michael Bow. He had nothing during the first three quarters. Now looking for his fourth here in the fourth quarter. This is going to be a big moment for Mike. He makes it. Time is out to 2 minutes and 22.5 seconds. It's a 2-point game. Still Gilbey. Here Hoffman never enjoyed the lead. We have had only 3 deadlocks. The last time out was 38 off. Here's a big J. Big pass. Look at Mason. At the wing. Just a big J. Looking for a cutter. He locks him over everybody. And somebody tagging with this mic will try to cut him off.
Yes, this game is getting very physical. You can see there's a difference.